Nearly 200 families have been displaced in the Bicol region as heavy rainfall triggers flooding and landslides in several provinces. Some localities are also without power, but no casualties have been recorded. State Weather Bureau Pagasa says the rains, which began on Sunday, are caused by the combined effect of the shear line and the extension of a low-pressure area.
Based on the meeting with Pagasa, we may still experience heavy to torrential rains until tomorrow. There are no information if power supply has been restored in the 7 LGUs which reported power interruption. But hopefully, for today, their power may be restored.
Five police officers sacked over their alleged involvement in the kidnapping of an online cockfighting executive in Laguna. Philippine National Police Chief Rodolfo Azrin Jr. signed the dismissal orders after the PNP's Internal Affairs Service found substantial evidence against them.
Definitely, hindi na po ito makakabalik sa serbisyo, Sir Mar, dahil nga napakahigpit po ng panuntunan na mabigat po ang sinampang kaso sa kanila, grave misconduct. Kahit ano pong leverage ang gamitin nila para po ibalik sila sa serbisyo, I doubt po makakabalik pa po sila sa serbisyo po sa bigat po ng kaso na kanilang kinakaharap po.
Three of those who were relieved have also been indicted by the Justice Department prosecutors for robbery and abduction. They're accused of pretending to be National Bureau of Investigation agents who stormed the house of Ricardo Lasco in August of 2021 on the pretense of arresting him for alleged large-scale estafa. China's continued aggression shows a complete disregard of international law. That's according to Senator Francis Tolentino. He says while China is not required to respond to note verbales, it should at least admit the incursion being done by its Coast Guard in Philippine waters.
They have ignored it, and their manner of incremental and continuous ignoring of our protests would just show that this is a trend, this is a pattern, so to speak. But what the government has been doing, and even the previous administration has done, is correct. Even if they don't reply, it keeps on piling up. And later on, it can be used against China by the international community, by our government as well, to justify that the violations being done even after the issuance of that arbitral ruling are continuing.
For now, Tolentino says government can look at other ways to assert the country's territorial rights in areas being claimed by China.
You can beef up our resources within Calayan Islands. More classrooms, more livelihood programs in the area. It would really show that it is ours. The area is sustainable. You don't need a supply from other areas to support life. There should be economic activity. There are people living there.
The U.S. backing the Philippines in the face of China's increasing aggression in the West Philippine Sea. Washington calls on Beijing to respect the international law of the sea amid the escalating swarming of Chinese vessels in Philippine waters. The U.S. says China's presence not only affects the livelihood of local fishing communities, but also reflects its disregard for other claimants. The U.S. also raising concerns over the Chinese Coast Guard's seizure of a rocket debris from Philippine naval forces last month. The Philippines filed a diplomatic protest over that encounter.